Taoiseach, I will be travelling to Fermanagh for the protests at the G8 and speaking at one of the alternative summits where the policies of the G8 will be critiqued in Belfast on the day before the summit. And I have to say that I'm very concerned, as are people who are protesting, very concerned about the enormous hype of security and talk of threats around the summit. And I have to say, I'm very disappointed, Taoiseach, that you are echoing some of this narrative in advance of the G8 summit by alluding to possible threats from protesters. And you talked about smashed window screens, for example. Yeah. But you're throwing it into the narrative, okay? Sorry. Isn't it the case? Sorry, isn't it the case, Taoiseach? Sorry. Isn't it the case?
Questions, please.
Isn't it the case that a broken windscreen does not scream with agony in the same way as a child that is blown to pieces by a drone weapon deployed by the United States in Afghanistan? Let's get things in proportion. There is no comparison between blowing a child to pieces with an unmanned drone who is entirely innocent and a broken piece of glass. And the reason people are protesting with peaceful intent is because they find it stomach-churning that the leaders of the most powerful global nations in the world talk about peace, talk about global justice, and at the same time are the ones who are deploying weapons like that to such devastating effect, extinguishing the lives of innocent children and families. And where the United States, for example, is the major manufacturer, purveyor and user of weapons of mass destruction, as are these G8 powers. So what I want to ask you is, Minister, will you echo the concerns of the protesters in saying to Obama and Putin and the other powerful states that produce these weapons, use them, sell them, that people are right to express concern about all of that money and resources of humanity being used, hundreds of billions being spent on weapons and war and means to destroy human lives, and that that's why they are protesting, and that you, as the Prime Minister of a country who established its identity in the struggle against empire, want to speak out on behalf of those people and say that their concerns are justified, or that they are justified in being critical of the fact that the major recipient of aid from the United States is the State of Israel. Most of that is military aid, and that military aid is used to devastating effects against the innocent people of Palestine in attack after attack that is conducted by Israel against the people of the occupied Palestinian territories. Will you speak out, and will you say these things? And will you say, finally, Count Corner, will you ask President Obama, which has now been confirmed, as some of us said 2 years ago, why his Treasury Secretary vetoed a proposal to impose some of the burden of the financial crisis in this country onto bondholders? Why did he do that when it had such a devastating effect on the ordinary citizens of this country, and when we have learned from Cyprus, it wasn't necessary, because it was possible to burn bondholders without the entire financial system falling apart? We've learned that now. But we were spun the lie at the time that we couldn't do that, and we know that the critical intervention came from President Obama's Treasury Secretary to say we cannot burn these bondholders because it might impact on certain corporate interests in the United States. Will you challenge the US administration over that and over the devastating effect it has on our citizens? And very finally, will you demand in advance of the G8 summit an assurance from the Northern Ireland authorities and from our own Gardaí that peaceful protesters will be left alone, that there won't be phalanxes of robocops intimidating and terrifying peaceful protesters, trade unionists, environmental activists who want to go up and raise these legitimate points, whether you agree with them or whether the GA agree with them or not.
Could I ask Deputy O'Donovan and Deputy Murphy to put their questions before the Taoiseach finally replies?
Can I ask the Taoiseach?